वक्रतो नमः महाकाय सूर्यकोटि सम्प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीवाख्यात उच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्सुपन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीं हृदयदां जाड्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां दत्त्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां पुण्यां करोम्यहम् पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघु सिद्धांत कौमुदी। कंटिन्यू विद दी अच्छंधि। दी नेक्स्ट सूत्र इज यरो अनुनासिको निर्नासिको वा अनुवृत्तिस पदांतस्य संहितायां। सो यरः अनुनासिके अनुनासिकः वा विभाषा। देयर इज एन ऑप्शनल जस्ट गिव मी अ मोमेंट। यस ओके बिकॉज समबडी इज ट्राइंग टू जॉइन एंड देन इट्स इज सस्पिशियस। ओके सुमिकी यू आर मार्क्ड एज सस्पिशियस बाय गूगल व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू एंटर। ओके सो यरह यरह परस यरह इज स्थानी यर यरह यर प्रत्याहार यर यरह अनुनासिके परे व्हेन एन अनुनासिक लेटर फॉलोज देन दिस यर विल गेट व्हाट अनुनासिक वा सॉरी नॉट अच्छंदी आई एम सेइंग विल कंटिन्यू विद दी दी वी स्टार्टेड विथ हलसंधी आई थिंक राइट या सो झलाम जशोंति इत्यादि वी डिड सो नॉट अच्छंदी संधि प्रकरण बेसिकली वी आर एट हलसंधि सो यर For some reason the auto join is not working. Okay, padanta yar, the yar should be at the end of the pada and followed by an anunasika. Then what happens is that optionally there is an anunasika adesha for this yar, yar letter. And yar happens to be what? It is in the Hayavart Sutra start dropping ha, hakara. And then in Shasasar Sutra, which is followed by Hal Sutra, they are also dropping Hakara. Therefore, all consonants except Hakara, all consonants except Hakara are included in Yar. So, all consonants except Hakara will take Anunasika Adesha optionally when followed by Anunasika. The condition is that the yar should be at the end of the pada. So example is what? Etasya murarihi, etan murarihi. Etad plus nyas plus murari and su is a samasa. So etad and murari are left when the nyas and su undergo lopa by look by supodhatu pratipadikayoho. Then etad murari dakara is a पदांत यर लेटर एंड मुरारी मकारा इज अ अनुनासिका देर बाय दकारा विल टेक अनुनासिका ऑप्शनली सो व्हेन इट टेक्स ऑप्शनल आदेशा इट विल बिकम अनुनासिका आदेशा इट विल बिकम एतन नकारा दकार विल बिकम नकारा बिकॉज दी त वर्ग दकारा हैज वर्ग पंचमा एज नकारा सो वर्ग पंचमा इज द अनुनासिका nasal letter that will be etan murari as the ending form etan murari and then this is the pratipadika it will declare etan murari hi pakshe what pakshe etad murari dakara will remain dakara and you will get etad murari so this is one form this is the second form there is a vartika on this as a pratyay bhashayam nityam so this optionality is taken away generally we don't look at vartika in the recap But then, this is important as to pratyay bhashayam nityam. The optionality is taken away, and there is a nitya anunasika adesha in bhasha. In bhasha means in laukika prayoga. So the example is given as to what pratyaya. So when pratyaya pare, when pratyaya follows. Now when will a pratyaya follow a pada? Not in a samasa. It will be only when you have a tadhita kind of a situation or what else? Mostly a tadhita kind of a situation or when you are deriving a dhatu maybe. But then from a basically a namadhatu, that may be a possibility, but the example mostly is what tadhita. So tadhita pratyaya is matrach pratyaya. So when matrach pratyaya follows pratyaya bhashayam in laukika prayoga, then this pada tad padanta dakara, which is a yar letter, is followed by makara of matrach pratyaya, which is nunasika. Therefore you cannot have tad dakara remain dakara optionally, it has to be mandatorily replaced by nakara. So you will get tanmatra. So tanmatram, chideva chinmatram, these are examples for matrach pratyaya. For mayat you have chideva chinmayaha, that kind of an example. Mayat pratyaya is in swartha, swarthe mayat. So chinmayaha means chit itself, consciousness itself is called a chinmayaha. Of course vikara is possible, but chaitanya in sampradaya, vedanta sampradaya, does not have vikara. Although it is said as chaitanya vikara, it is all vivarta, it is not parinama. Therefore the final meaning even with vikara arthe mayat will also amount to saying swarupa or swarthe. The next sutra is torli, sandhi sutra is torli. Anuvritti is parasavarna samhitayam. So parasavarna is the adesha. The savarna of what is following is the adesha. For what? For lakara, which is preceded by, for tavarga letter, which is followed by a lakara. So torli means tavarga letter, in shashti it will become toho. So tavarga letter is sthani. When so li pare lakara, lakare pare will get parasavarna. Parasavarna means lakara's savarna in tavarga. So this tavarga adesha, not in tavarga, for tavarga, whatever is the lakara equivalent in tavarga, that will be the adesha, savarna equivalent. So examples are what? Tavarga se lakare pare parasavarna, tasya layaha. So tasya layaha is a samasa, shashti tatpurusha. So tasya layaha, tad plus laya, tad plus nyas plus laya plus su, these pratyas will go away by supodhatu pratipadikayoho, look. Then tad and laya. So now you have dakara, which is followed by lakara. Dakara is a tavarga letter, it is a tu, and lakara is li. So li pare, satisfying the condition li. So toho li. Pare, what is the adesha? Parasavarna adesha. So toho stane li pare. Parasavarna means lakara savarna. What is a lakara savarna for dakara? So there dakara, basically what savarna will be, parasavarna, not the savarna of lakara itself. So any of these tatha dada na will have lakara adesha only, because there is no other equivalent there. So parasavarna savarna will be what is savarna for lakara, of lakara in tavarga. You will not find a savarna as in lakara savarna. So none of those are really the adesha. I mean tavarga is not the adesha. So tavarga letter will take lakara adesha, except that the varga panchama nakara will take nasalized lakara as adesha. So either it will be lakara if tatha dadha precede or adhisthani. If nakara is sthani, then nasalized lakara na. La will be the adesha. Nasal is lakara. So that will be the adesha. So tad layaha will become tal layaha. Tal layaha. Then vidwan likhati. Vidwan likhati, you have a nakara varga panchama of tu, and li pare lakara is following. So li condition is satisfied. Tu is preceding, li is following. So tu will take, tu nakara will take nasalized lakara adesha. So you'll get vidwan likhati. Now remember this. This is the only place where the consonant you see, other than nasalized consonants, varga panchama letters, they are taking the nasalization. Adi as adesha. when you write this, it is difficult. Most people will end up writing. So you'll see this anuswara is on laka, first lakara, which is followed by another lakara. It should not be preceding. It is not that akara is nasalized, but lakara itself is nasalized. So if you read this, it is possible. You can say vidvalna, vidvalna. Whereas you read this likhati as likhati itself. So it is vidvalna, not vidvan likhati, but vidvan likhati. So at lakara, when you are pronouncing lakara, that time the nasalization should come, not before that. It is not akara which is nasalized. Many people while typing, because while typing, it is very difficult to get this akshara. But this is how it should be. So when you type it together also, you should get vidwal here. This should be the nasal vidwal likhati. This anuswara should not shift earlier or later. It is not after this ni. Vidwal likhati is wrong. Vidwal likhati is also wrong. Vidwal likhati. So lakara is nasalized. Difficult to pronounce also, I agree, but technicality should be known. So nasya anunasikaha la. So lakara is here. You see, lakara is nasalized. It is not that lakara has an akara following. That akara is for uchcharana artha, but the lakara itself has to be nasalized. The next sutra, sandhi sutra, is udastha stambhov purvasya savarna samhitayam. So ud is the particle which is preceding what? Stha or stambh. So stha or stambh are the, basically they are, you know, these are dhatus. So purva savarna is adesha. So dakara is purva. So dakarasya savarna, which is savarna for this sakara, or whatever this sakara or stambha, stha or stambha sakara takes an adesha. We'll see what is that exactly in the derivation. But the dhatu stha and stambh, the initial letter of that will take dakara savarna adesha when preceded by only ud, not any dakara preceding, but it should be a ud particles dakara. So udah parayo stha stambho purva savarna. So now we can derive it, but then paribhashika sutras which we have seen are covered here as to tasma ityuttarasya nirdishtat and then adev parasya alaha. So these sutras we have seen, these are needed to identify which is the exact sthani. So tasma iti uttarasya, the karya which is, meaning vidhi which is ordained in the place of what? Tasmariti, in the place immediately after the fifth case. So the tasmariti uttarasya bhavati, whatever is the vidhi that will be applicable to the whatever is indicated by fifth case. So udaha, udaha is panchami here. Udaha, udaha is panchami. So udaha parasya. Sthastambho is anyway in shashti. So which is sthani? Generally we have seen sthani will be the last letter. So sthani here, stha or stambha is the stha or stambh is the sthani. So which is the sthani? They are not the last letter. So what has to be said is that the first letter is the sthani. Why? Because udaha is in fifth case. So this fifth case in the sutra indicates that whatever follows this ud particle, that letter is sthani. How do you land there as to identify the sthani? So tasmar iti uttarasya. So the karya will be applicable to what follows the fifth case in the sutra, whatever is said by the fifth case. So udaha is the noun for tasmat. So tasmar is a pronoun. What does it stand for? Udaha. So tasmar iti uttarasya means udaha. There you replace udaha is panchami. So iti, udaha iti, when udaha has been said, then uttarasya, whatever follows ud, what is that? Stha or stambh, that will be the sthani. Now which exact letter is the sthani there? So adev parasya. So whenever the vidhi is given, देन व्हेन यू इन द फिफ्थ केस आदेहे परस्य, सो परस्य आदेहे, परस्य आदेहे अलह, द विच लेटर विल बी द स्थानी, परा इज द स्थानी बट परस्य आदि इज द स्थानी. स्था एंड स्तंभ हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड एज स्थानी बाय तस्मार इति उत्तरस्य, बट व्हाट एग्जैक्ट लेटर इज द स्थानी इन स्था एंड स्तंभ, द फर्स्ट लेटर, सो आदि, दैट इज सेड बाय द आदेह परस्य. दीज पारिभाषिक सूत्रस वेर नीडेड टू अप्लाय द उदफ पूर्व सवर्ण, सो वी हैव द सूत्र टू इंटरप्रिट उदस्ता स्तंभ पूर्वस्य, दिस पूर्व सवर्ण टू अप्लाय पूर्व सवर्ण टू विच लेटर इन दि स्था एंड स्तंभ, फॉर दैट वी नीडेड दीज टू पारिभाषिक सूत्रस, देर फोर लघुकार इंट्रोड्यूस बोथ दि सूत्रस. नाउ वॉट इज दि आदेश पूर्व सवर्ण, सो पूर्व सवर्ण दकार पूर्व सवर्ण, सो देर अनदर सूत्र कम्स इन टू प्लेस एज टू आई डोंट थिंक या सो हियर सॉरी बिफोर दैट इति सस्यतः, सो द लघुकार से वॉट इज द नाउ सकार इज द स्थानी ऑफ द स्था धातु और स्तंभ, सो स्था और स्था सकार और स्तंभ सकार विल टेक थकार एज आदेश बिकॉज पूर्व सवर्ण दकार, सो वॉट इज द पूर्व सवर्ण फॉर दकार इन द विच इज इक्वेलेंट टू सकार, सो सकार एंड दकार बेसिकली दकार एंड सकार इफ यू लुक एट वॉट हैज टू बी दि आदेश टर्न्स आउट टू बी त थ द ध न, इन दैट त थ द ध न द आदेश हैपन्स टू बी थकार विच इज वॉट द महाप्राण ऑफ दकार, सो दकार विथ महाप्राण बिकॉज सकार हैज सम एस्पिरेशन, महाप्राण इज एस्पिरेशन, देर फोर दकाराज इक्वेलेंट और सावर्ण विथ सकार विल बी थकार, सो थकार इज द आदेश फॉर सकार, सो विल गेट उद and then sakara will become thakara, so you have double thakara, ud and double thakara in sthana stha dhatu, there stha dhatu has been, sakara has been replaced by thakara, so you have double, you have basically tha, ud and tha, this nam is from lut pratyaya, so lut your anako will give you ana for you, so you remains which is replaced by ana, so this is the pratyaya content, but you have stha, stha which is following, so stha stambh, stha or stambh should be following this ud, then this dakara will influence sakara to become thakara. Now the next sutra is introduced because another sandhi takes place here, jharo jhari savarne, so jharaha shashti, jharaha jhari pare, jharaha savarne jhari pare, which kind of a jhar should follow? That should be savarna to this jhar which is preceding. So halaha anyatarasyam lopaha sanyatayam are the anuvritti shabda. So samitayam samitayam vishe lopaha sya anyatarasyam. Anyatarasyam is a big word to say va, vibhasha. So there is a vibhasha given as to for some reason my eraser is not working. So anyatarasyam also means va, vibhasha. So halaha, halaha is panchami ekvachana. So after a hal, this jhar which is followed by savarna jhar, this jhar will take optional lopa. Meaning it will be elided optionally. So what do you have here? You have two thakaras of sthadha. Sthadha to sakara has been replaced by thakara. So there is a thakara here which is a jhar. There is another thakara which is a jhar. This is a savarna jhar. So thakara and thakara obviously they are same letter, so there is savarna in between them. Now hal is preceding or not? Ud dakara is preceding. So this dakara is hal. So after this dakara hal, this thakara which is a jhar followed by savarna jhar thakara, the first thakara can optionally be elided. So if you elide it optionally, you will get single thakara, otherwise you will get two thakaras. So you'll have two forms. One is with two thakaras, one is with single thakara. So we'll see the optional forms later as to at the end what will happen, because more is going to apply. I mean, more are going to apply more sutras. So the next sutra taken is Kharicheva. Unfortunately, Laghukara takes Kharicheva later than the Jharojhari Savarne. Why unfortunately is because 8465 in Tripadi is later to Kharicheva, which is 8455. So this is later. So in the sequence, if you look at it, Kharicheva 8455 is applied after 8465. But this is an optional elision. So if you don't elide it, then the form will be different. If you elide it, the form will be different. Now, which is the sutra which has applied earlier to this? The sutra has applied is not Adev Parasya or Tasma Iti Uttarasya, but in derivation, Udasta Stambho Purvasya has applied. So without this 8461 applying, Udasta Stambho Purvasya, if you go to Kharicheva, it's a Kharicheva is 8455 and Udastha Stambho Purvasya is 8461. So you cannot apply Udastha Stambhasya unless you apply Kharicheva. That will be the scenario. But the derivation is showing Ut plus Tha. So when you are deriving Ut plus Tha, as soon as you utter Ut plus Tha, then the sutra which is applicable will come to mind as to Udastha Stambho Purvasya. That is why in the Prakriya he has taken that sutra earlier. Otherwise also you can see, however, in whichever sequence you apply, what this Kharicheva sutra sees and what as to when you apply this Kharicheva sequence is what 8455 Kharicheva. Then you have 8461 in sequence, Tripadi sequence. 8461 is Udastha Stambho Purvasya. And then 8465 is the earlier sutra as to Anyatarasyam, Jharojhari Savarne Anyatarasyam, Jharojhari Savarne. So Jharojhari Savarne is 8465. Now in the sequence, if you apply, when will Kharicheva apply? When you are adding Ud plus Tha. So here if you apply, what will happen? See, Khar is what? Khapa chatata chatatau kapai shashasar. So Sakara is included. So when you apply this sutra, this Sakara is Khar, which is following Kharicheva. Adesha is Char. Char is the Adesha. So Jhalam Char. Sthani is Jhal. So Kharicheva Jhalam Char Samhitayam. I want to apply in sequence and show you. That's why I wrote it on the side. So Kharicheva Jhalam Char Samhitayam. Samhitayam Vishaye Jhalam Shashti Bahuvachana Sthani. So Jhal letter will take Charadesha. What is Char? Char is Varga Prathama. First of the class. So first of the class is Char. And not entire Char also. I mean Char is what? Khapa Chatatav Chatata. So you have in Khar. See, Char is part of Khar. Khapa Chatatha. Then Khapa Chatata Chatatav. So starting with that. So first five are the second of Khar is starting with the second of the class. So second of the class is dropped. Then first of the class, which is part of Khar, is included. So what is the Adesha really? The Adesha is Char, first of the class. So the second of the class, Kharicheva, when second or first of the class or Shashasa follow, then first of the class is the Adesha, which also includes Shashasa, but generally you will see Adesha as first of the class. So the Jhal will take first of the class Adesha. And what is Jhal? Starting with Jhavai. So Nyamagana Nam has to be set aside, meaning fifth of the class has to be set aside. So fourth of the class, third, second, first. So fourth, third, second, first of the class, then Shashasar, all of those. And Hal, Hakara, all are included. They are replaced by Char as Adesha. So here Dakara should be replaced by what now? By char. Char dakara is second of the class. Ta tha. Third of the class. Ta tha da dha. So you see the takara, which is the varga prathama, is the adesha here. You will get ut. So you hold on to this ut form when you are deriving. Ud has become ut. Ut and this sakara, then later will become what? Ut and double thakara or optional lopa will give you utha or ut utha. So you'll get either utha or double thakara utha. That is the form. That why? Because kharicha will see sakara. Even if you have changed the forms and you have landed on this udtha, this thakara is not the nimitta. Thakara is, see, thakara kha pha cha tha tha cha tha tau. So kha pha cha tha tha cha tha tau. There thakara is the second of the class. So kharicha, it will still work, but then it is thakara is not the nimitta. Nimitta is sakara, because the 8455 sutra will not have any idea of 8461 and 8465 karyas, because they are parakarya. Purva sutra in Tripadi cannot have the vision of the karya of the later sutras. So even if you apply it, the 8455 kharicha sutra later, still it will see only sakara. So that's an aside to tell you what is the sequence in which it should really apply. But anyway, the example taken is udastha. So the lagukara has worked with the udastha stambo of purvasya, because they are specific dhatus. He has taken that sutra earlier, and then he has taken whatever is needed there, and then he landed on kharicha later. So there kharicha jhalamchar, so you will get ut. So here you get utthanam. So one form is ut and single thakara, the other form is double thakara. So this is mentioned as lopa abhav pakshe. If you do not take jarojari savarne lopa anyatarasyam, you do not take that option of lopa, then two thakaras will remain and you will get utthanam. So this is the second form. This is the first form, utthanam. It is mentioned here. See, note in the view of the 8455 sutra, thakara is asiddha. Instead, sakara is the paratnimitta. So the stha sakara or stam sakara, stam sakara is the nimitta. Sorry, I can't erase it, therefore I am right. Stam sakara, I hope it is understood. That sakara is the nimitta because it is khar. The next sutra is again jayo honyatarasyam. Purvasya savarnaha samhitayam. Again, purva savarna is the adesha. For what? For jay. Jay, not for jay, for jay which is preceding a hakara. The hakara. So, for a scenario where jay precedes hakara, meaning hakara which is immediately preceded by jay is replaced optionally by purva savarna, meaning savarna of jay. And what is jay? Starting with the fourth of the class, third, second, first, kapai. So you exclude the fifth of the class. Nyamagananam is out, then jai is fourth, third, second or first of the class. So when fourth, third or second or first of the class letter is preceding a hakara, that hakara can optionally take purva savarna, savarna of the jai. So what is savarna of this hakara, savarna in jai? So it happens to be the fourth of the class. It happens to be the fourth of the class. Generally, you will see fourth of the class as the adeshta, because hakara is also, you will see mahaprana there. You will have aspiration there, and mahaprana is either in the second or the fourth place in the varga. So in ta tha da dha na, thakara and dhakara are the mahapranas. What is more proximal to hakara? Dha is more proximal than tha. So therefore, dhakara will be the adesha. Generally, you will see fourth of the class as the adesha. Let's take an example. So, vachi harihi pandita vagharihi. So, vach, samasa is between vachi and harihi. So what remains is watch and hurry. So watch, hurry is chakara, is followed by ha. First you will have to go through the sequence, you will get choku. Choku is cha varga, chakara is replaced by ka varga kakara. So that has taken place. Now this, before we reach our sutra, you still have jhalanjashvante. So this is a pada, padanta kakara, which is a jhal, will take jash adesha, third of the class. So kakara will be ka ga, gakara is the adesha, varga tritiya, jashtum. So after this gakara is jhal, is a jhai. This gakara being jhai, followed by hakara, this hakara will take optionally varga chaturtha adesha. So gakara followed by hakara, the influences the hakara to become varga chaturtha of what, the same class as this gakara. Gakara belongs to ka varga, so ka ka ga, gha, gha is the mahaprana there, which is by sthane antartamaha is having savarna with hakara. So that hakara will become ghakara. So you will get vaghari. This is one form. If you do not take the option of jayohu anyatarasya, anyatarasya is vibhasha va. So hakarasya jayaha purasavarnaha adeshaha syat va syat. So if you do not take this option, then you will get vaghari. So hakara will remain hakara. So you will get vaghari or vaghari. Both forms are okay. Then there are some examples given as for cha varga, ta varga, ta varga and pa varga. You see, ukalo jhraswa dirga plutaha. There this hraswa hakara has become jhakara. Why? Influenced by this jhakara, which is a jhai. After jhakara, mahaprana is the adesha. This is jhakara. Then ta varga example is syat. Syat takara has become dakara. By what? By jashtum. So first takara, then takara has become takara. Takara because of so whatever is the sequence there, we are interested in dakara form. This dakara or takara will both influence the hakara to become varga chaturtha. So after dakara, mahaprana is dhakara. So varga chaturtha will be dha. So hakara has become hraswa dha. Has become dhraswa. Then durad bhute, we saw this in pluta. This so durad bhute hakara will become mahaprana of dakara as to dhakara. So durad bhute. Then abhasti, water elephant, up. Hasti, bakara is the jashtam of pakara, pa pha ba. Then this bakara will influence the hakara to become mahaprana of bakara, which is bha, bhasti, abhasti. So these are the examples. Next sutra is shash choti jayaha anyatarasyam samhitayam. Let me there's too much of noise, it's raining, but then kids are playing. Let me close the window. Is playing, it's my neighbor's kid who is yelling from the balcony. Okay, so shash choti jayaha anyatarasyam samhitayam. So what is the sthani here? Shakara is the sthani, shankar shakara, preceded by jay and followed by at. Here there is a vartika ami iti vachyam. So at should be read as am. At ends with hayava rat, but am is further to that. So हयवरट लंड झबई, सो हयवरट झबई, सॉरी हयवरट लंड, या लंड लकार इज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड, दैट विल बी एन एग्जाम्पल देर. देन न्यमगणनम, सो न्यम अप टू न्यमगणनम शुड बी इंक्लूडेड, दैट इज वॉट द वार्तिका सेज. सो दिस अट शुड बी अंडरस्टूड एज अम. हियर इट्सेल्फ इफ यू सी वी कैन गो स्लाइटली फास्टर. सो झय, सो शकार शंकर शकारा सैंडविच बिटवीन अ जय एंड एन अम ऑप्शनल टेक्स छत्वम. छकार आदेश ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज छत्वम. सो एग्जाम्पल इज वॉट तद शिव. सो तद शिव इफ यू हैव दिस तद शिव देन स्तोश्चुनाश्चु विल अप्लाई फर्स्ट बिकॉज इट इज 8440 सूत्र खरी चशुडे 63. सो 40, 55, 63 दैट इज द सीक्वेंस ऑफ एप्लीकेशन. सो वेन यू अप्लाई इन दिस मैनर स्तोश्चुनाश्चु दिस दकारा विच इज टू टू इज अ स्थानी इट विल टेक चू आदेश. सो तथ द विल बिकम च छ ज जकारा. सो दकारा विल बिकम जकारा बाय स्तोश्चुनाश्चु. देन खरी च दिस शकारा इज अ खर लेटर. सो खरी च झलाम चर. सो विल गेट चर आदेश. चर इज द फर्स्ट ऑफ द क्लास. सो जकारा विल बिकम चकारा. सो दकारा सेकेंड ऑफ द क्लास. थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास बिकेम सॉरी तथ द ध. सो दिस फर्स्ट दी देर इज अ क्लास कन्वर्जन. सो थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास ऑफ त वर्ग बिकेम थर्ड ऑफ द क्लास ऑफ च वर्ग. देन दैट च वर्ग विच चर आदेश च वर्ग जकारा हैज बिकम फर्स्ट ऑफ द क्लास चकारा. सो तच तच शिव दिस चकारा इज नाउ वॉट नाउ वी हैव दिस सूत्र इज अ झय. सो चकारा इज पार्ट ऑफ झय एंडिंग विथ कपई सूत्र. सो दिस चकारा इन्फ्लुएंस इज दिस शकारा विच इज फॉलोड बाय एन अम. इज इट फॉलोड बाय एन अम. सो इकारा इज एन अम. इकारा दिस शंकर शकारा इज प्रिसीडेड बाय चकारा विच इज अ झय एंड यू हैव इकारा विच इज पार्ट ऑफ अम प्रत्याहारा. देयर फोर दिस शकारा विच इज सैंडविच बिटवीन दीज टू झय एंड अम विल टेक छत्वम ऑप्शनली. सो यू विल गेट तच शिव दिस इज वन फॉर्म और यू विल गेट तच शिव विच इज दिस इज द सेकेंड फॉर्म तच शिव. तो तच शिव और तच शिव. सो अमी इति वाच्यम इज वार्तिका वी सॉ दैट. वॉट इज एग्जाम्पल फॉर अमी. सो बियॉन्ड द अट इज अम. सो ये लकार लण सूत्र लकार इज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड देयर इफ यू से अम. That is an example. Tat shlokena will become tat shlokena optionally. Otherwise, without the vartika, you cannot get this form. So this is an example for vartika. Next, halisandhi is monuswarha. Padasya hali samhitayam. So samhitayam vishe hali pare. When a consonant, any consonant is following, where padasya. So padasya makarasya. पदांत मकारा दिस मकारा एट द एंड ऑफ द पदा वेन फॉलोड बाय एनी कॉन्सोनेंट विल टेक अनुस्वार आदेश. सो मकारा विल बिकम अनुस्वार. नाउ दिस इज फॉर टू रीजन्स. वन टू देर आर सम दिस देर इज अनदर सूत्र विच विल कम अप एंड कन्वर्ट दिस मकारा इंटू समथिंग एल्स. नॉट मकारा बट अनुस्वार इंटू समथिंग एल्स. सो मकारा इज रिप्लेस बाय अनुस्वार अनुस्वार एंड देन कन्वर्ट दैट. बिटवीन दैट कन्वर्जन दैट टेक्स प्लेस लेटर and this makara which is converted into anuswara, there may be some sutras which may have some change to makara. You can see that that makara which has become anuswara will be protected from such change. That is also one reason that you can see that makara is hidden away as anuswara and then it can even be brought back to makara later. So you see that that kind of a brilliance in this set of sutras also. It's just an aside, it is not important here, but just to say as to why one may get a question, why is this makara converted to anuswara when it is going to become makara again later. So there that question need not be entertained. If at all such question comes to mind, you can see the brilliance as to how these sutras in between would have ended up changing that makara and it has been protected by converting into anuswara. So what affects a makara may not affect an anuswara and then you bring back that makara with another sutra. Once all these karyas which are needed for some kind of letters they may have applied to makara had it not been converted into anuswara. This is an aside. So example is what harim vande. So harim vande makara maha makara makarasya anuswara adeshasya कदा स्यात् हलि परे. वकारा इज अ कॉन्सोनेंट देयरफॉर. सो व्हाट डज दिस मीन. दिस मीन्स दैट दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके दिस इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. पीपल राइट वॉट फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस मकारा. सो आई एम जस्ट ट्राइंग टू थिंक ऑफ एन एग्जाम्पल. वेर एवर यू हैव अ वॉवल, लेट मी जस्ट आई एम नॉट एबल टू गेट एन एग्जाम्पल राइट ऑफ द टॉप. सो let's say there is anu, let's just read this itself. So harim, let's say there is harim anu something, anu vande or something, anu. So harim anu following har hari. So harim anu. Now this sutra specifically says that only hali pare there should be aniswara adesha. Anuswara adesha itself is not there if hal is not following. So when a vowel is following, people should not write or pronounce anuswara. Harim anu, many people take this option of harim. This is asadhu in writing or in pronunciation. It should not be done. And people think that instead of writing makara fully, this dot is equivalent. It is not equivalent. It's a separate letter and pronunciation completely. It can have different pronunciation based on what follows. So in Hindi, in Marathi, in Kannada ityadi, maybe that is okay. But then in Sanskrita, we should never write an anuswara or pronounce an anuswara when it is followed by a vowel, because that adesha has never come. Thinking equivalency between makara and anuswara is not right. It is not just a nasalized let, because let's say makara is also nasalized, anuswara is nasalized, therefore you think that it is same. It is not same. There is never an anuswara adesha when a vowel follows. So this is completely wrong. Just this is important, that's why I'm mentioning this. There are many people who have this samskara from either other languages or while learning Sanskrit itself, their teachers have taught them wrong. It is not the, the fault of the teacher also, because the teacher learnt it that way. There is an influence from other languages or school teachers who themselves have no knowledge of sutras. And it is easier, so they think there is a short form. It is not a short form to write. It has, anuswara has a separate meaning than makara in pronunciation. Therefore, they are not the same. They are not interchangeable. And we'll see how this anuswara should be treated later. This anuswara should also not be held as anuswara optionally. In other languages, they are. Like for example, you see a word shanta. So shanta can be written this way, and this you see in many Sanskrit books also. Shanta. This may be okay, shanta in other languages, but this should become nakara. So this is right, this is not right. Optionally, sometimes if it is there, then it may be right. But then optionally, if it is not there, as we'll see, there's no option mentioned, then it should be written in this manner. Anuswara is a conversion by one sutra. You cannot have a choice in which sutra you'll apply and which sutra you'll not apply. You should apply all the sutras. If you apply all the sutras, then shanta will be the form. Optionally, whether this anuswara remains or not is a question that has to be answered. And as we study, we'll see this is not an option. So this is important, because I have seen many, even many teachers make this mistake. They know, but then they are not alert to this. And students unfortunately end up following the same thing. They think that's a shortcut to write, and there is no difference between what you write and what you pronounce, like unlike other languages. That's why Sanskritam, Samyak Kritam. So what you see is what you get. What you say, Vaisivig, in software terminology, it's called Vaisivig. What you see is what you get. What you see is what you pronounce. What you read is what you pronounce. Therefore, there is no difference between written and pronounced. Writing it is only for our ease, but the language is a spoken language. So Harim Vande, back to Harim Vande, Makara becomes Anuswara, and then you get Harim Anuswara Vande by Monuswara. Then the next sutra is Nascha Padantasya Jali. So Nascha Nakarasya Cha by Cha Makara also. This Makara is drawn down from the earlier sutra because of this Chakara. So Cha says Nascha. Nakara also means what? Makara remains. Apadantasya. So for Makara, which is at the end of the Pada, was the Sthani. Now this makara as well as nakara, which is not at the end of the sthani, which is not at the end of the pada, becomes a sthani. When does it become a sthani? When it is followed by a jhal letter. So the situation is that a pada is there in which there is a makara or nakara, not at the end, but in the same pada a jhal letter follows this makara or nakara. Then this makara or nakara becomes a sthani and gets a mandatory anuswara adesha. Example is what? Yashamsi. So yashas plus jas will get yashas plus shi adesha, jas shoho shi. These are sutras which you have not studied, they'll come up. So just amout sasityadi, jas shoho shi. Then yasha will take num agama, napunsakasya jaraja. So you'll get num agama. That agama will come in, nakara is the content. So yashan, sakara, and then e. She content is e, shakara is an eth letter. So you'll get yashan si. So this nakara, this is our sutra, nakara. Now this nakara, of course, this yasha has become yasha by upada dhirga, by shanta mahata sanyogasya. So this nakara caused dhirga to yasha akara. So now this is where we'll have the application of our sutra. What happens is nakara, which is apadanta nakara, because the entire pada is yasham si, this entire yashas plus jas is the entire pada, supting antam padam, this is subanta pada. So in this subanta pada, this nakara is a apadanta nakara, followed by sakara. What is this sakara? This sakara is a jhal letter. So this will influence this nakara, apadanta nakara, to become anuswara. So you will get yasham si. Therefore you will not pronounce nakara. They are not equivalent. Nakara becoming anuswara has completely changed the pronunciation of nakara. You will not have nakara pronunciation. You will not say yashansi. Yashansi is wrong. In some people in Hindi will use that. It is okay in Hindi, whatever is their grammar or whatever is a corruption there in Hindi also, let them handle it. But we should not pronounce yashansi. So there are two ways how this anuswara should be pronounced. So you follow your sampradaya, whatever it says. Generally Vaidika sampradaya has a pratishakha. So pratishakhya rules override the vyakarana rules in chandasa prayoga. And whatever is the chanting, that continues in the loka also, those who have Vaidika samskara. So in Sringeri sampradaya, this anuswara is pronounced as makara. So you give yashamsi. And in Maharashtra side, in Marathi and in Kannada, outside the Sringeri sampradaya, there is yashamsi. So this will become nasalized and you will get kind of a yashamsi. There is a difference. You can make out if your ears are tuned, you can make out the marked difference between these two. Both are okay, whatever is followed. The makara introduced by insisted by Sringeri Patha is because there are many people who come from various places at Sringeri, and to in Vaidika chanting, to maintain a standard, they said that all should pronounce this as makara. So you get yashamsi only in this kind of a scenario. When yakara or sakara, ityadi, repha, those follow which do not have an equivalent. And at other places also generally people pronounce makara. That is okay in Vaidika chanting, but outside the Vaidika chanting, that is also incorrect. They have samskara from Vedas where for chanting they have used it. So Pratishakya rules override them, but those samskaras remain, and in the loka also the such pronunciation is there, but it is not appropriate. Anyway, it's just an opinion. The next example, you see this, I'll not go through all these examples. Makara, but it is a padanta nakara. Akramsyate is an example. So we'll go further. Anuswarasya parasavarnaha. So you see this from 8324. From this we are jumping to what? 8458. So in between these a lot of things have taken place which will not apply to this makara and nakara, which has been converted into safely protected as an anuswara. So anuswara is not part of any pratyahara. Anuswara not being any part of pratyahara, whichever pratyahara is a sthani between these sutras where makara or nakara are included, they do not undergo change. बिटवीन वॉट 8323 एंड 8458. सो देर आर सो मेनी चेंजेस दैट आर टेकिंग प्लेस. इफ यू गो थ्रू दैम यूल सी सम चेंजेस मे हैव अप्लाइड टू मकार और नकार ऑल्सो, विच इज इधर पदांत नकार, पदांत मकार और अपदांत मकार और नकार. सो दे हैव ऑल बीन प्रोटेक्टेड. नो नन ऑफ द प्रत्याहाराज विल इंक्लूड अनुस्वार. Therefore, this anuswara which has been protecting the makara at the end of the pada or makara or nakara in between the pada, a particular with particular conditions, that anuswara will take parasavarna adesha when followed by yai. So yai is any consonant except for hakara. So whenever any consonant except for hakara and shashasa also, kapai shashasa, so hakara is not included, and then what else is not, shashasar is also not included. Shashasar, so these are also not included in yai. So other than these, any consonant that follows an anuswara will force this anuswara to take parasavarna of yai. So what is a parasavarna there? Laghuvritti says pashtam. So example is shanta. We saw this. Sham plus ta anunasikasya kvijjalok niti dhirgha. So sham upada there is a dhirgha. Akara has become akara. So you get sham plus ta. This makara followed by takara actually this entire thing is a pada. This sham is not a pada. Sham is a modified form of sham dhatu, and this entire thing is a krudanta pratipadika, not even a pada. So sham plus ta is a pratipadika, it is not a pada. It is still in the prakriya avastha to become a pratipadika, let alone pada. So this it is an apadanta makara. This apadanta makara, which is followed by jhal, will nascha by nascha apadantasya jhali. Nascha will include anuswara, and there is anuruti of makara also, maha. So that has been mentioned. Maha makarasya api apadantasya makarasya nakarasya cha jhali pare anuswara adesha hoti. So makara has become anuswara. This anuswara, how should it be pronounced? So since takara is following anuswarasya, after this 8324, lot of changes go on between these, but this anuswara comes back to what? Parasavarna of yai. So it can become makara also. Had the pa varga letter followed, then it would have been makara. But the ta varga letter follows, therefore savarna of the ta varga is what? Varga pancham of ta varga, which is ta tha da da na. Therefore this anuswara will be pronounced as nakara, so it will become shanta. Now is this optional sandhi anywhere? Anuswarasya ehi parasavarna, nowhere is it said as optional. Anuswarasya ehi parasavarna samhitayam कुत्रापि वा अन्यतरस्याम इत्यादिकम नास्ति. Therefore what it has to be pronounced as nakara only, and when you are pronouncing it as nakara, there is no option to write it as anuswara also. This anuswara, even if it is written so, the pronunciation is nakara, so it is better to write it this way, not as shanta. This is important because such samskaras will remain. These two are separate words. Pronunciation, another sutra is applied, therefore this conversion has to be done. So although it is written this way in many books, even older books have it in this manner, unfortunately they should be written as shanta and pronounced as shanta. Now only difference was vapadantasya anuswarasya yai parasavarna when, only optionally when it is at the end of the pada. So padanta anuswara, not the shanta anuswara, but the padanta. This shanta anuswara, this anuswara is not at the end of the pada, this is apadanta. In the sutra there is nothing called as apadanta, but I have to read this as apadanta, and mandatory in the case of apadanta, this nakara is mandatory. When is it optional? Only when this anuswara had it been at the end of the pada. So example is what? Example is tvam karoshi. This tvam is a pada. You, tvam karoshi, you do, you are doing. So this tvam makara being at the end of the pada, it will have by munuswara, it will have been converted to anuswara. This anuswara, being a padanta anuswara, will get an optionality. Va is only padantasya. This is a padanta. This is a padanta anuswara. Padantasya anuswarasya yai va parasavarna adeshasya vibhashaya. There you can make it as it can remain tvam also, second form, or it can remain tvam also. So you can say tvam karoshi, or you can say tvam karoshi. So if you say, if you do not make it as varga panchama, meaning yai, parasavarna of yai, what is the parasavarna? Kakara, ka varga, varga panchama will be the pronunciation nyakara. So tvam karoshi, either it will be tvam karoshi or tvam karoshi. When tvam karoshi, when you do not make this sandhi, then this anuswara can be pronounced as makara when there is a pause in the padas. So when you are reading it, you will say tvam karoshi without a pause. If you pause it, you will get tvam karoshi, tvam karoshi. So this is an optional form only when it is at the end of the pada, not before the end of the pada, not apadanta. Therefore I said that in apadanta, like in shanta, this is mandatory. This is not an optional form. You cannot have anuswara at all. It has to be converted to nakara. And why should it be mandatory? Because people have samskara of pronouncing anuswara differently based on their matrubhasha separately. So that can also influence. Even if you write in this manner, how to pronounce it changes across languages. We do not know all languages. Therefore also it is better to be written in this manner than in the with the anuswara in the apadanta case. The next sutra is muraji samakkau mas samhitayam. So samhitayam vishaye makarah maha. So what does it say? Maha, maha is the adesha. Makarasya maha, makara adesha. So makarasya sthane he makarasya sthane makarah adesha, meaning makara will remain makara when raji pare. When Raj Shabda follows Raji Pare, and what? Samaha, which Makara? That Makara which belongs to a Sam Upasarga. Not Upasarga, maybe a particle. It may or may not be an Upasarga. So Sam which precedes what? Raj. Sam plus Raj. So you have Sam Makara. So this is not, so you will have this entire thing is Sam. Okay, this Sam has been written, but this Sam is entire thing is Sam. And that Sam Makara. So this makara is this makara, same as this. So sam makara when followed by raj, and what is this form of raj? Raj is a dhatu there which has taken quip adesha, not quip adesha, sorry, quip pratyaya. So quipi pare, because that is mentioned in the sutra itself, kau pare. Kau pare, kau is also what? So kau, raji and kau are not in samanari karanyam, but raj which is followed by kau. Or what? Kvibanta Raj Shabda. So Kvip is a Kakara is an ith letter by Lashakvatta Dite. Then Pakara by Halantyam. V remains. Then Vehe Apruktasya. Ekal Pratya. Aprukta means what? Ekal Pratya. A single Al that remains. That is Vakara, because Ikara in V. Kvip V. Vehe Apruktasya. That for pronunciation it has been added, but Ikara is also it by being nasalized. So upadeshe jannasika it lashakvatta dite halantyam, all three will take away except for vakara in quip. Then vakara ve apruktasya, a single letter pratina pratyaya is called as ekal pratyaya is called as aprukta. So that in aprukta which is vakara, vakara which is an aprukta, vehe apruktasya lopahasya. So that will also go away. So this quip is called as a zero pratyaya. Called as a zero pratyaya means easy to understand. There is nothing in the sutras to say it is what shunya pratyaya or anything. But zero means content is zero. That's why in modern teachers call it as zero pratyaya. Quip has no content. Then why has it been added? Kakara will protect some things. Then Pakara will make some other rules applicable, being an ith letter. So what happens is that this quip is generally going to make a karta. It's a Kridanta Shabda now. Raj. Raj will become a Kridanta Shabda. Quip will go away. Raj Dhatu has been converted into a Pratipadika Raj एंड देन व्हेन यू डिक्लाइन इट ऑल्सो यू विल गेट राज. सू लोपा विल टेक प्लेस, द पदा विल ऑल्सो बी राज. सो इन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ सिनेरियो दिस राज इन द सेंस ऑफ कोर्स संधि सूत्रास विल अप्लाई बट राज विल बी द जकार विल टेक वॉट एवर आदेश आर एप्लीकेबल पदांत संधि इत्यादि विल अप्लाई. सो संपूर्वक राज धातु दैट सम मकार इज वॉट going to take what makara adesha, meaning it will not become anuswara. 8325, look at it, 8325, after covering many sutras later in the fourth pada also, lahukara has gone back to what we saw, this 83 23 24. So we saw 83, I'll stop after this, but okay, we have gone far ahead. So see, 83, sorry, I went too far. I just wanted to go to Mohanuswara. Went too far. So Mohanuswara is 8323, then 8324. But it's in sequence. I got lost. So 8458 was covered. Then he went back to Mohanuswara and Naschapadantasya Jali and continued from there as to what? There, this Makara at the end of the pada becoming an anuswara, because some is in what, in some gana, it will be in some gana. Where is it mentioned? Is it there? Some in which gana? I think it will be in pradi gana. So anyway, in whichever gana sum occurs, this sum makara, sum, it will be considered separately as pada also. So in sampradaya, sum itself can be considered as pada. Therefore, this makara at the end of the pada, or in the prakriya avastha, if sum is not considered as a pada, then it will be apadanta makara. Apadanta makara followed by repha. That repha of raj is what? So meaning, why was this sutra needed? Makara becoming anuswara. See, makarasya makara adesha. Makarasya makara adesha makes no sense unless some change is already ordained. So what change is ordained? Anuswara is ordained. So there is a scenario in which if this sutra hadn't existed, then makara would have become anuswara. So Panini Maharshi does not want this makara to become an anuswara. So he wants to keep this makara as makara. Therefore, what is the adesha? Anuswara is not the adesha. So this is a sutra which is negating the earlier application of anuswara. So makara itself is yadesha. Makarasya makara syat. Meaning makara will remain makara. So kivante rajatau pare samaha masya makarasya maha eva syat. Maha eva syat means anuswara na syat ityartha. So you will get what? Ram plus raj plus quip. You will get samrash. So by what? Vrascha, vrascha, srujam, ruja, yaja, raj, bhraj, chasham, shaha. So shakara is the adesha. For what? For vrash, vrascha, srija, mruja, yaja, raj. Our word here is raj. Raj is the dhatu, bhraj. And chakara ending and shankar shakara ending. So all these dhatus which are specifically mentioned, and this chakara ending dhatus and shankar shakara ending dhatus, will take Shanmukh Shakara Adesha. Last letter. So Raj Jakara will become Shakara. So this Jakara will become Shakara. As we see here, Jakara has become Shakara. So you'll get Shamrash. Sam will remain, Makara has not become Anuswara. So Samrash, and then Jhalam Jashuante Padasi, you'll get Samrad. Then Vavasane Char, you'll get Samrad. So one form is Samrad. Samrad, second form is Samrat. We'll see this Vidhi Sutra in the next part. Bhutavasane Nataraja Rajo Nanada Takkano Panchavaram Uddharatu Kamasanakadi Siddhan Etad Vimarshe Shiva Sutra Jalam. Namaste, Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.